Crisis communication and negotiation is about when we have we are in a situation whereby everything need to be you know, in very strict procedure in order to face the challenges that we have. So later on in the later slide, I will define what is crisis. Yeah, but now actually we are living in a crisis days. Actually, in this COVID-19, we are actually really experience what is crisis all about. Previously, it is difficult when we try to explain what is crisis. Crisis usually occur when we have fire, when we have natural disasters, when we have accidents, for example. But nowadays, when we are living in this under this COVID-19, we are actually living in a crisis situation. Every day, we need to follow strictly the procedures being implemented by the authorities in order for us to survive in this situation. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Similar. I'm wearing same shirt. I got my vaccine this morning. Today is the first day. We in UMS, they are giving the priority to the top management first lah. VC, our vice chancellor, our deputy vice chancellors, main officers, the directors, all they got the vaccine today. Since I am one of the management team as director in Center for Sustainable and Society Engagement, I also given the chance to have my vaccine today. So actually, this photo was taken this morning at 10 o'clock, roughly around, I think not 10 o'clock. I was injected at, I'm still having the plaster, you see the candy plus here. Yeah. This morning at around 9:30. And it's funny actually. Previously, people heard about vaccine. This vaccine is harmful and so on. This is my personal experience having been vaccinated today. Actually, vaccine is very good. It's safe. It's safe actually. What make people, of course lah, there are different groups about this vaccine. But at the end of the day, it is about whether you have your body shield or not. Okay, having vaccine is about having your body shields from being attacked by virus and so on. So that is a vaccine for vaccine to protect us, to minimize from being attacked by the disease, by the virus. So that is vaccine. Actually, what worried people the most is they are afraid of being injected. You see, I put my thumb up, being injected. And funny thing is, it is, you know, I don't feel anything when being injected this morning. I even asked the nurse, nurse, sudahkah? Because nurse already, I was surprised, I was already injected because I don't feel any pain at all when being injected. Yeah. In Malay, I can say in Malay, sakit lagi digigit semut api daripada diinjek. Because maybe one thing is the nurse done it properly, and the needle is not that big. And secondly, I am confident. Okay, it is about confidence. When you are confident, you don't feel the pain. Yeah. So. But of course, before I was injected, one of the procedure is for the nurse, the doctors to take our blood pressure. Actually, my blood pressure is always around 130 to 140, sometimes go to 145 and I wonder how come this morning my blood pressure went to 170. Yeah, 170. You know what is 170? 170 means I should take, medicine every day. And later I found out that actually I'm the kind of people, when I see hospital, I'm nervous. When I see medicine, I'm nervous. When I see people as sick, I'm nervous. But I did not show it physically. But deep in my heart, emotionally, I actually nervous looking at the death. This is what we call white coat. White coat. I'm one of the category of people under the white coat. White putih coat baju lah. So what is white coat? White coat refers to the doctors wearing the white coat. So when I see, when I'm in that environment, suddenly my blood pressure came high. So that's why this morning, when the doctor first checked my blood pressure, 171 below 101. Wow, so high. And then secondly, 104 below 101, still high. Then the doctor decided to change the machine, to change the machine, and we use the new machine, the new blood pressure calculation, what we call it, machine lah. So machine, and still the new machine, my blood pressure is 107 below 104, confirm. I am one of the white coat people. But actually, when I'm in a stress situation, I easily, my blood pressure easily went to 165 and so below lah. But this morning 170 something. I think one of the reason why my blood pressure came that high because for the three consecutive nights I'm watching Euro 2020. Less sleep. So actually there are many factors. Yeah, there are many factors causing our blood pressure to increase, to rise. And when we took the vaccine in our Dewan Kuliah Perdana, the place that you are supposed to have your class, yeah, we have the vaccine there. And because my internally I'm nervous, so that's why the blood pressure going high. After I took the injection, I was put under observation for 30 minutes. Then I went home. I reached home about 11 o'clock. I took some sleep lah, napping. Actually, I just woke up from napping. I sleep around 12:30 like that. And then I just wake up just now. Took shower and seeing you all lah. So actually, my point is that when we have crisis, we have some procedures to follow. We have do and don'ts. Yeah. So in this crisis communication and negotiation, I divided it into two parts. Part one is on crisis communication. Later part is on negotiation handling. Yeah. For crisis communication, I'm going to share with you five objectives. The first objective, learning objective, LO stands for learning objective. The first learning objective is I'm going to share with you what is crisis, how do we define crisis. Second, what actually we face during the crisis. Of course, we are facing some issues and challenges. And the third one, how do we go about this crisis, the planning. And learning objective number four, how we adapt to the situation so that we can face the crisis effectively. This is learning objective number four, construct effective and responsible messages. Okay, of course, during crisis, you are going to do a lot of communication when you give commands and when you discuss with your team. And finally, how do we handle complaints and rumors? Complaints and rumors, of course, people will talk many things during crisis and so on. So, and you are going to receive so many viral news, and most of the viral news are fake news. So these are what you are going to learn in topic number 8, crisis communication. So far, so good, everyone. Okay, Kak?
Okay, sir.
Okay, make sure. Kalau
okay, sir.
Okay, if say I do the talking but no voice from your part, alert me. Otherwise, nanti saya shock sendiri bercakap sama laptop, kan? So make sure you alert me. If suddenly technical error occurred, I hope if some of you still not inside. If your friend asking to enter this room, do it for me. Okay. So the first one, the first slide, in this first slide, it defines what is the crisis. If you look at the rock there, the graphic, usually when crisis, people are running away from crisis. That is the analogy. The analogy of this slide is when there is crisis, everyone try to escape themselves. Okay. They don't care about others. So this is the things that people forget to understand. Actually, during crisis, we should not run away. Okay, we should not run away. When there is crisis, first thing we put into our mind is how to save ourselves. How to save ourselves. If we cannot save ourselves, how can we save others? So basically, when crisis occurred, we don't run away, but we save ourselves. For example, in this comic, there is a story behind this comic. Yeah, this comic is telling that when there is a crisis, we run away. Cannot. If you cannot run as fast as the rock will bump on your head or your bodies. Yeah. So what happened is you move left or right. Save yourself first. So crisis is actually occurred without people know that is going to occur. It is going to occur in which usually crisis it has a synonym of catastrophe. Yeah, catastrophe that may occur either naturally, for example, earthquake. For example, what else? Etc. lah. I forgot already. Those catastrophe that we unknowingly had occurred. So and it also caused by human error. Human error, for example, two days ago, I watched from YouTube about the plane crash. Flight crash. Yeah. So when I look at one video, it brought me to another video. In these 3 days, I watched about about plane crash, kapal terbang terhempas. What happened is when I watch the videos on plane crash, I try to differentiate the disaster, the crash, due to the pilot error and due to the technical error. Technical, I'm referring to, for example, suddenly the plane got fire, for example. So that is what we call technical error, technical malfunction. Technical malfunction. So usually when we talk about plane crash, it is for two reasons, whether the pilot errors or the plane technical malfunctions. So these are example of crisis lah, crisis kemalangan udara and so on. And I found that if the crisis due to the human error, the pilot error, there is always steps taken by the pilot or the crews to save the plane. Okay. In fact, if the crisis due to the technical malfunction also, at the very last minute, the pilot and the crew will try to save the plane. So this is a case in which actually when we are facing crisis, we are going to take a spontaneous action. Okay, a spontaneous action. Only with that spontaneous action, it can save us from the crisis or minimize the impact of the crisis. But for us to have that spontaneous action, we should undergo preventive measures by having a related training and so on. So for these pilots and the crews, they actually have all the training on how to handle crisis if crisis occurs. The only problem is when the crisis is due to the technical malfunction, which is out of the training that they have undergone before. So basically, most of the cases of plane crash is going to be a terrible disasters when it is technical malfunction. Yeah. So intervention, malicious intent, as well as disease and disasters. So COVID-19 fall under disease. Yeah. And in order for us to minimize the crisis, we need to know what is the priorities. Know the priorities is actually what to do. What do we need to do first in order to minimize the impact? And we must have management plan. That is the step by step or the procedures. For example, this COVID-19, one of the government effort is to have this PKP. MCO is part of the management plan on how we control the spread, the widespread of this disease COVID-19. And then we assume crisis always happen. This assuming crisis always open, this one is related to any organization. Any organization, it must assume one day there is going to be a crisis taking place in this organization. What is the crisis? For example, fire. For example, human error lah. I'm trying to say like corruption and so on. I'm trying to say like bribery, scandal and so on. But it is also a crisis. So every organization should think that one day crisis is going to happen in this organization. So how are we going to handle the situation? So that's why in human resource management, we need to have officer or personnel on handling crisis. We need to have trained our people, I mean employees, on how to handle crisis. And the last step to handle crisis, we must show empathy. As I said earlier, by looking at the graphic, the two people running away from the rock, actually they are not showing empathy to others. They are saving themselves. Of course, saving ourselves is priority, but to minimize the impact of the crisis to the mass or more people, we must try to how our existence can assist to mitigate the impact to others. So showing empathy is about saving people first, okay? Giving people a priority, all right? So inside the rock, I wrote, due to the increasingly digital makeup of the media and the ever-present social network community, a breaking corporate crisis is likely to be reported within minutes. Okay, this statement referring to that usually before the crisis make formal, people spread the very short news about it first, which can be not truly reported, but people already talk about it. So usually people from media, especially when they heard crisis, they will search for the news from relevant organization, and they will always look for person to contact. When I was in my previous department, before I'm in this, the current department, which is Center for Sustainable Society Engagement, I was the deputy director for corporate communication in UMS. Yeah? So usually my side is the one who always handle the crisis with regard to UMS lah. Any crisis reported about UMS, I'm one of the team members who handle the media, the reporters. Usually they will ask me, what is that story true, for example. So if that story true, how are you going, how UMS is going to face the crisis? So basically, by my profession, before, I am the crisis handler for UMS. Okay, so next. Okay. These are the characteristics that you can learn so that you know how to, you know, to prepare yourself to handle crisis. Okay, the first characteristic of crisis, there is always a surprise. Nobody know that crisis is going to occur. Meaning to say, spontaneous act is mandatory. Meaning to say, when crisis occurred, happen to organization, don't panic, because that is the characteristic of crisis. It comes when nobody knows. So knowing that it has an element of surprise, that means you are reducing your panicky level. Okay, so number one, and don't lose control, because crisis is a surprise to everyone. Insufficient information. When we have crisis, of course, we don't have so many info about the crisis. I refer this one to when I handle crisis in UMS, in my previous position, the journalists, reporters, texting me, or they call me, they ask for more information from me. So the first thing I did, I can consider myself as experienced crisis lah, crisis handler. I'm one of the experienced crisis handlers. So what happened is handling. What happened is, I always say to the reporters like this lah. Sorry, for the time being, I cannot reply to your question, but I promise you. I say like that, because it's very important to build a good relationship with media, because media will promote our organization. So I will tell them, sorry sir, for the time being I don't have any information about the issues, the crisis, but I promise you, once I got the info, you will be the first to know. At the end of the day, all of them first to know lah. This is the tips. If you have become the crisis managers, please, don't cooperate with the media, but make sure you have, first, you have the full information. Second, you have the permission to give the news, the info to the reporters. Otherwise, that's going to be a trouble. We are afraid that whatever info we share with the media, if we don't have enough information, it is going to be reported wrongly. So we don't want that. Okay. Then the quick pace of event. Okay. Crisis is not going to take a long time. Different from COVID. Different from COVID. COVID is about, we still don't have the cure. It it is going to take long time because we don't have the cure, and this COVID-19 is already airborne, not from physical touch anymore. Airborne. This is what we read lah from latest info. So for COVID, we only managed to slow it down, by follow the SOP, standard operation procedure, on how to mitigate the COVID. But it's going to end soon. I believe that it's going to end very soon. The most important thing is for us to follow the procedures. So I'm trying to say for normal crisis, it's not going to take a long time. Yeah? For example, the fire take place from 8 o'clock in the morning until noon. So that is the crisis time. But for crisis like COVID, it's different. Okay, so meaning to say, crisis only take certain time. Intense scrutiny. This is the part whereby it tests our endurance of handling the crisis. Every minute, every hour, we are subject to give answer. Before I forget, this crisis characteristic, I meant for if you are the person in charge of the crisis in the organization lah. But it's good for every employees. One day you will be working or have your own business. Every employees to know about crisis characteristics, right? But the crisis characteristic here, this idea, this info is actually for those handling the crisis. So most important thing, if you are the caretaker of crisis, you are the one being responsible to handle the crisis, you have to know lead, build, and know. Okay, lead, build, and know means that lead during crisis, you should lead the crisis. What do we mean by lead the crisis? Okay, for example, I give very good example like my experience with the reporters. When the second stage, when I have the info, I call the reporters, or I call all the reporters. I ask them to come to office and I brief them about the situation, why the crisis occurred, for example. Yeah. So actually, my act is I'm leading them. Okay, this is what called I lead the crisis. I trying to mitigate the impact of the crisis to the organization, the UMS. So I call the reporter, I give them some news, I tell them what actually occurred, who fault is there, and so on. So this is the act of lead a crisis. Management, when you are being attacked, without info you being attacked, and then you find the info, that is managed. When the fireman serving people in the burning house, they don't have any knowledge of, not firemen lah, maybe people around the house which is burned, and these people want to save the victim inside the house, they don't have the training, they don't know what to do, they are not the firemen, and they actually try to manage in saving the victims. But for firemen, they lead in saving the victim because they know what to do. So that is the differentiate how actually when we have crisis, we lead, not we manage. Build crisis muscle means that, again, I want to use the ideas when I had experience in my previous position in UMS as crisis handler. I get the relevant information from relevant department first before I furnish the detail to the reporter. So this is what we call build crisis muscle. You have to build your strength. You have to build the proper text to, you know, to extend to the reporters. And the third one is know your environment and calibrate strategies and communication accordingly. So this is the part in which you know what you are doing lah. You know, this one you can refer to the previous slide. Okay, insufficient information. If you have full information, you know what to do. Okay, the left side, you can refer with the color. Yeah, for example, lead referring to, you look at the left side, the box here, behavior and action. Blue here referring to build. Yeah, blue here. Red here referring to red in the circle. I already mentioned to you just now when I explained these three. Yeah, basically to go further detail, knowing, leading and build, you refer to the left box. Okay. In crisis, we actually has three phases. Every crisis has three phases. The first phase is when crisis is yet to occur. This is what we call pre-crisis. We do not know when crisis is occur, but we always remember, okay, look at the previous slide. The previous slide said the element of surprise. Crisis is the element of surprise in which we don't know when is the pre-crisis. We just, every organization must, must think of crisis is going to happen. Where is that? This one. Assuming crisis always happen, number three. So because of that, pre-crisis is actually the phase in which we assume crisis is always is going to happen. So we have to do some preparation or taking some mitigation, avoiding crisis to occur, and what are the prevention. And when crisis occurs, we can respond immediately so that we can overcome the crisis by doing the recovery plan. And then we develop here after we can lead the crisis, build crisis mission. No, accordingly is referring to the development. Okay, and then after the crisis, of course, we need to do some study. After we undergo any crisis, we should do the study so that by having this post crisis, we can avoid the similar case to occur in the future. Okay, or to avoid from other kind of crisis, as at least we have the experience. So that is why it's very important to have post crisis. Okay, this slide referring to the action need to be taken during crisis. Basically, the idea is that when we hear something, what should we do? Okay, when we saw something, what need to do? So that is what we say, control the situation. Any crisis, we need to control. And then try to gather as much information as possible. And then set up centralized crisis management center. When we face crisis in organization, we must have a team. And this team need to be comprised of representative from different department in organization. Yeah? In organization. And then we communicate early and often, understand the media mission, okay? Understand the media. This is what I shared with you all. When the crisis occurred to big organization like UMS, is always going to be the focus of attention to the media. So this media, they actually want to be the first to publish the news because they are competing among medias, right? So basically they will ask question immediately. So you must know the reason for why media want to know. So better not to give the information straight away unless you have full info and you have the permission from your boss. Communicate directly with affected constituencies. This one, actually, when you have crisis, of course there are some big victims involved in the crisis. Okay, so these victims actually represent the constituents other than the organization. So when we supply info, we consult the victims. Because of maybe there is some element of dignity of the victims involved. And then you need to plan to avoid another crisis immediately. Okay, planning process. Okay, in crisis communication. Crisis communication is actually about it is actually about public relation. Okay, crisis communication is about public relation. How well you face the crisis and during that situation, that duration in handling the crisis, you are actually building relationship. As I said before, not only with the reporters, but also with the victims, but as well as another stakeholders involved in organization. So knowing that, when we handle the planning process, we must know who are the stakeholders. In this slide, I show to you, organization is our organization lah. If you are working in any organization later on, or you have your own organization, the stakeholders are employees, consumers, media, government and regulators, global citizen, activist members, and volunteers, community investors. These are example of stakeholders. When we handle crisis, when we do the planning, actually we are doing communication. And that type of communication is public relation communication. It's very important for us to know who are the stakeholders. So while mitigating, while overcome the crisis, we are actually strengthening the relationship. Okay, this is the ideas lah. Steps of crisis communication. Basically, these ideas is similar to the previous slide. Let me show you. For example, this one, and this one. So basically, this is step of crisis communication. These steps is formed based on the previous info that I share to you in the slide. So this is one step by step. And this step actually I took from the book, and I also include my experience in handling crisis here. Yeah. Crisis anticipation, choose your crisis communication team, select spokesperson. Okay, in any organization, the choice, the selection of spokesperson is very important. If the crisis is about the organization as a whole, the spokesperson should be the big boss, okay, the number one in the company. In organization, maybe the CEO. For example, last few years ago, when MAS, MAS airline, has had this catastrophe, for example, MH360, missing flight. So the CEO of MAS, I still remember, Ahmad Jauhari, become the spokesperson. He always give press release every evening. So he is the spokesperson for Malaysia Airlines System that time, Ahmad Johari. Okay, and in major crisis, the spokesperson could not be normal officer. It should be the number one officers or the one that being chosen by the number one in the company or in the organization to be the spokesperson. It could be the communication managers. It could be human resource manager. It could be deputy director and so on. Yeah, but the normal practice when we have crisis, the spokesperson is the big boss, number one in organization, unless he or she ask other person to act on behalf of the organization. Training of the spokesperson is okay lah, training, setting up and the monitoring and notification system, getting to know your stakeholders already, holding statement must be prepared, make sure you have info, analyzing the situation, you have the critical ability, thinking skill and so on lah. Somebody who lead the crisis team must be not only wise but has specific abilities. I don't know what is specific ability in any organization, okay, but actually the one is should be the leader, not the manager, when handling the crisis. Prepare final messages. This one usually when we provide information to the media, we have to have the press release, for example. So in the press release containing final messages from the organization. And of course, after the crisis, we do the post analysis. So far, okay, semua, everything all right? Everyone okay? Clear? Hello, everyone, clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
All right, thank you. I hope there are 100% clear. Okay, crisis management plan. This is the plan. If you remember, I go back to the previous slide. Yeah, this one, crisis response, recovery, development. So what actually we do during this crisis? What actually respond, recovery, and development? So this slide show you what is actually response, recovery, and development awareness lah, similar ya. It is a plan that define operational procedure to deal with a crisis, including communication tasks and responsibility. The key ideas of management plan is how are you going to communicate in your team, within your team, and how are you going to communicate with the public through the media. The second one is responsibilities. The responsibility, if you have team, what is the responsibility of each one in the team. So this is what I want to share with you all, that in crisis management plan, there are two key ideas in crisis management plan. The first is how communication is going to go about. Secondly, what are the responsibilities of every individual in the team, all right? Learning objective number four, we already in learning objective number four, message structure for crisis communication. So I would like to refer this to press release. Okay, when we have crisis, country have crisis, state has crisis, organization has crisis, we must prepare a statement, because media want to have this statement, and this statement actually is going to be shared with the public. Usually media is the one that always share the info to the public. So what happened is we need to prepare a press release, a statement. So how are we going to prepare a statement? Number one, we must express concern. Remember I said empathy. Okay, empathy referring to we put people first, we put others first, we put the victim first. So always in the press has the statement with the ideas of saying we are so sorry. I don't know how are you going to write it, but that is the key ideas. When we prepare statement, the first thing we need to understand is that crisis is occurred in our organization, you know, involving our personnel or whatever. So we cannot say we are not wrong. We cannot say we are not wrong if crisis is in our organization. So we need to somehow say that we try our best, but it occurs, and we only can mitigate, we can reduce the impact. So this is what we call express concern, empathy. Yeah? Provide instructions. So for those big teams, for example, we already prepare, allocate this and this to minimize the sadness of the victim. So for this particular example, I'm referring to the catastrophe crisis of MH360, for example, the missing Malaysia Airlines plans last time. Yeah? And then provide compensation, apology, and then explain corrective action, provide instruction, excuse, justification. We provide justification, we don't give excuse, and then provide compensation. This is the basic written communication an organization has to prepare when they have crisis. Once crisis communication team have planned the messages, they must act under significant time pressure to compose them. As I said in previous slide, yeah. Okay, intense scrutiny. Now look at intense scrutiny. Intense scrutiny means similar to this word, time pressure. Okay, so of course everything need to be done, need to be prepared in a rush hour. Okay, so in order for us to prepare a correct press statement, for example, we need people in the team who are expert in their field, who are representative of their department, so that when we construct the press release, we have good feeder of information, because in the team they are representative with integrity of data, right? Responding to external complaints and handling negative rumor. So nowadays we have this, everyone has, I can say lah, everyone, but not everyone, but actually most people nowadays, they have handphone. And this handphone is already a smartphone, so everyone can hear, can read news not in a minute anymore, in a second. Yeah. So how we can, you know, go about this? So we need to have these steps. Yeah, this step, gather the facts, and so on. Yeah. So this one you just read, and I believe you all understand how to apply this when you have crisis, when you face crisis. There are six people you need on your crisis communication team. Basically, this slide refers to who should be in your crisis management team. If you are in big organization, so of course you have different departments, and for big organization they always have HR department, human resource department. So human resource department could be representative by one person individual lah. And so the rest, yeah. For example, in UMS we have the keselamatan, the bagian keselamatan, so they are one of the member in the crisis team. We have SCP, student affair, we have academic division. So all these they need to provide one particular person to be in the team of the crisis team. Yeah, and according to this write-up, public relation is number one of the team members. marketing, of course, legal, product management, information security, investor relations. So this depends on what is the niche, what is the business of the organization, what is the social obligation of the organization in order to form the team for crisis management communication. Okay, everyone know Tan Sri Isham, the Director General for Ministry of Health in Malaysia. He has been working incredibly well to fight COVID spread in Malaysia. Almost every week or every day, we see him supply the information nowadays through social media, and so on. And then this is so Tan Sri Isham actually the spokesperson. We call him the spokesperson for Ministry of Health. Okay, basically I want to ask you all this question lah, but you can go through this question by yourself. Just to, this one can be used to enhance your understanding. Yeah? For example, why the Health Director General Dato Isham always appear in the press conference? Because he is the spokesperson and so on. What is the most important thing in the PC is press conference. What is the most important thing in the press conference? You answer yourself. Why is it crucial for the authority to declare conclusion of investigation? Okay, spokesperson number one. Okay, accuracy. The most important thing during press conference is accuracy. As I share with you my experience being contacted by the reporters, I tell them I cannot release any info yet because I don't have the right info, and also I need permission from the organization to release the info. So basically in press conference, we need accuracy. And why do we need to put a conclusion in any crisis? Because without ending the crisis, it's impossible to expect growth in the organization, in which until we have the end of the crisis, then we are going back to the normal, so we can work in stability so that economic growth can be achieved. So government is trying to faster the process of concluding this COVID-19 lah. The most important is people responsibilities, citizen responsibilities, people responsibilities to follow the rules. And as I said, crisis management is about public relation. Okay, public relation in which you need to handle people in the organization, internal and stakeholders external. So in social age nowadays, to handle crisis, you need to know how to handle social media. How can you differentiate between fake news and the true news and so on. Economic responsibilities, these are some of the credible relationship, credibility, ethical responsibility, social responsibility. This is only extra info. Okay, part two, I go very fast, we already 1 hour. Negotiation. In negotiation, actually, it is how people, when people are not in the same opinion, when people not in having the same opinion, how actually we can improve their relationship. So basically, negotiation is for us to achieve a favorable situation to everyone, especially those in opposite opinion. So that is the idea of negotiation. to the drastic example of negotiation when we have this hostage taking terrorists and so on lah, hostage taking police with criminal. So this is also the drastic situation of negotiation skill needed. Yeah, so negotiation is about conversation, how we communicate that the other party or the other people will, you know, come to our term, so that the issues, the crisis will be over very soon, very soon. Usually when in negotiation process, these are the three fears. These are the three fears in negotiation. Knowing these fears, we can reduce the duration of negotiating. The first is fear of developing a poor relationship. People don't want to lose any quarrel because maybe they want to stick with the relationship, or maybe they want to end the relationship. And sometimes people don't want to lose the negotiation because they are ego. They don't want to be looked at as person with failure. Yeah? And fear of rejection. Once you are not negotiating well, your image will be tarnished sometimes. So basically this is the perception why people afraid of doing what characterize people when they do negotiation. Knowing this, you can win any negotiation. Yeah? When to and not to negotiate. You negotiate when, okay, this one you read by yourself. Yeah, these are do and don'ts. When do you need to negotiate? When you no need to negotiate. Phases of negotiation, similar like crisis handling, you must do planning, preparation, bidding, setting the deal, confirming the deal. So you just read this one, straight info. How to be a good negotiator. You must be a person with high passion and listen to people. You must have this empathy. You are empathy listener. Self-confidence. You believe in yourself. You believe in your idea. You believe in the strategy that you are using. Lack of inhibition. Less sense of belonging. Attention to details. You focus. You have good critical thinking. Clarity in the thought process. You know very well the situation. Persistent, consistent. Ability to draw quick attention from other people. You are spontaneous type of person. So these are the qualities of good neighbors. Thank you. That's all. Will, knowledge and skill. WKS. Dr. Jack. Okay. Do you have any questions so far? Hello, everyone. Are you still sleeping?
No, sir. No questions.
Okay. So everyone, you have clear info from me today? Yes?
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Can I ask for the final?
Final, yeah. Boleh, no problem.
Okay, so we have one test.
Yeah, one test, the final one. That account for how much? I forgot already. 30% or 40%? 30%, right? 30%.
So we can attempt one.
You're talking about attempt. Similar like the last time, you have two attempts. So out of these two attempts, I pick the highest one, highest score. Similar like, you know, the format similar like midterm.
Okay.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Right. So you just read topic 5, 6, 7, and 8. Last week I provide you the asynchronous, the YouTube from YouTube. Basically, it is similar with that. So next week, I'm going to brief you detail, not detail lah, what is important in topic 7. And because by schedule we don't have any topic next week, right? This is the last topic, 8. So next week I'm going to more on, you know, revision, more on revision. And the 3rd July is the following week, I believe. Yeah, following week. This is on Saturday. Okay, I hope everyone is happy. Stay safe. Don't forget to read your notes that I provide. And usually this is one more tips. Yeah, when we are in universities, the style of reading is different like in school. In school, what you have in notes is usually exactly what is going to appear in the exam. But in university, what you have in notes actually to develop your critical thinking skill. Because during the exam or the test, it's not going to be exactly the same with the notes. But understanding the ideas of particular topic, you are going to be able to answer the question in the test. Yeah, that is the difference between school days and university years. Yeah, the question, the type of the question being asked. So you read the notes from the lecturers to understand the ideas. Using that understanding of the ideas, you will be asked by question which actually not exactly from the notes. Okay. So thank you very much, everyone. Don't forget to sign your attendance. Yeah. I still saw many students yet to sign clock in. You need to clock in. All right. Okay. That's all. Thank you very much. Don't forget to submit if you haven't submit your CSR project, your video and so on. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Bye.
Thank you, sir.